let's see another operation on set, that is union of a set. What is union of a set? The set of all elements of given sets is called union of set and shown by the letter U. U stands for union. Okay. So how it is written? Say for given sets A and B, how it can be defined? A, U, B. It means A union B is a set of all X such that X is element of set A or X is element of set B. For intersection, we have seen the word here, it was and here it is or. What is the difference between and or? In and, it should be element of both sets A and B for intersection. And for union, either it should be element of A or it should be element of B. So we'll collect all the elements of A and B in one set, of course without repetition, and that set is going to be union of A and B. Let's take the same example as we have taken for the intersection in previous video. Now the set A is say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, B is 2, 3, 5, 7. We have underlined the common elements and this, now what is therefore, what is A union B? Means what is the set? So we will write all the elements of set A and B together. So let's go in ascending order. So 1, after that 2, 3, 4, 5, these are in sequence. Now here 2 already taken, so we will not repeat. 3 already taken, so we will not repeat. 5 is also taken. Now remaining letter element is 7. So let's take 7, which is an extra element of B, and let's complete this. So this is the set of A union B. Now if we are showing this by Venn diagram, in two intersecting circles, in between part, this is intersection, common elements 2, 3, 5, remaining 1, 4 from set A and 7 from B. Now if you want to show this, the complete two circles are A union B. So we have to shade this to both the circles like this, and this shaded portion is called as A union B, complete circles. For intersection, we have taken only this middle part. Now for union, we have shared all this part. Okay. Now in the second example, in the previous video, say P is 1 to 10 numbers and Q is 1, 4, 9. What will be in this case P in union Q? In that case, we can see that 1 to 10 elements of P, and we have same 1, 4, 9 elements from the same set. So we need not to write in extra. So this A 1, 2, 3, 4, dot, 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 till 10. So we have got this P union Q is nothing but again is equal to what? P. So when P, Q is a subset of, so when Q is a subset of P, P is a smaller set. All elements of Q are elements of P. In that case, we found that P union Q is nothing but equal to P, which is bigger set. For intersection, we got Q, and for union, we got P. So, for subset, we write the first set which is smaller, and then here we write the bigger set. Okay, so for intersection, we got the smaller, and for union, we got the bigger set P. Now, let's take the example, third example, where X and Y are disjoint set. In that case, what will be X union Y? X union Y. So now we have to write how we write this both set together. So instead of writing all this 5 and then this 5, let's write in the ascending order. Let's write 1. Now 1 is here. 2 is not here, but 2 is here. So let's write 2 here. 3. Then come here 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you can put dot, dot, dot and 10 also. So it gives all numbers from 1 to 10 combining all these elements. So where we have this joint set, we have 5 these elements plus 5 in all 10 elements. Okay. Now let's see what are the properties of union of sets. As per our intersection, now it is for A union B is equal to B union A. For any two given sets A and B, whatever of A union B is going to be same as B union A. Now, if A is a subset of B, it means all the elements of set A are the elements of B. A is a smaller and B is a larger. Then, their union is going to be the larger set B. As here in this example, we have seen. Similar, same way here, different alphabets are used, but the meaning is same. And what is the converse of this statement? It is also true that if A union B is equal to B, if union of both two sets is B, then B should be the larger set, and therefore A should be the smaller set, and in that case A will be subset of B. Means we do not have any extra element in union other than B. In that case A is the subset of B. Now A is subset of A union B, as well as B is also subset of A union B. What is the meaning of this? Say for these two sets A and B, this is the A union B sets. Now all the elements of set A are the elements of this union set. So this is overwritten here. A, all the elements of A are the elements of A union B. It means A is a subset of A union B. This is one set and this is another set. This set is subset of this. As well as all the elements of set B are the elements of A union B. Hence, B is subset of A union B. Now, what will be the A union A dash? Means A set and its complementary set. Now, all the elements of set A and complementary set will give us universal set. This symbol looks like same, but here we have put it A union A dash, means A union complement of A is equal to universal set. This symbol is for universal set. What is A union A? Means union of A, it's with itself A, is nothing but again same set A. And what is the union of any set A with empty set? As empty set has no other element, its union is going to be again the original set A. Thank you.